benvinguts, tere tulemats, welcome to this presentation of the film that we are going to have the whole international premiere tonight, which is Free Life, La Vida Lliure, and we are really happy and glad to have here with us two main members of the team who has created the film. Depending who you say. So you are more filmmaker than he is?
No, I'm more little. He write the screenplay, he direct the movie.
Ah, okay.
It's better like this. No, he's very important for the movie. No, it's
as
a
you
joke.
As you see, it's not necessary to introduce them. No. So they introduce themselves really well. So I'm almost like leaving the room already. So we have here with us, by my side, Mar Recha, the filmmaker, author of this film. And Sergio López, one of the actors in the crew.
Yes.
I have many questions about the film. The film is, we will start with a question that is raising some interest lately, because I remember when we booked the film we selected for the program, they were asking me which was the language it was speaking, spoken, the film. And I said, well, it's Catalan, but not exactly, because it's menorquí. So
why? why you?
Bé, a la pel·lícula de A la vida lliure hi ha varis personatges. Hi ha gent que està a l'illa, no? La pel·lícula passa a finals de la Primera Guerra Mundial, el mes d'octubre, i ens centrem amb la mirada d'una nena, no, que es diu Tina.
The film is set by the end of the First World War and in October, in the month of October, and there are several characters. There are the people from the island and those from abroad, from outside the island, and the storytelling is based in the glance of the little kid, of the girl, vale, Tina.
I en aquesta illa de Menorca, que es diu Menorca, hi ha aquests personatges, que hi ha la Tina, en Biel, el seu tiet, i aquesta gent xerren menorquí.
And those main characters, Tina, her sibling, and their uncle, they are in Menorca, which is the name of the island, so they just speak naturally the language of the island.
I després hi ha un personatge foraster que ve de fora i que parla, doncs,
català occidental.
Occidental.
Sí, because it's the same. Sí, sí.
And then there is like an alien of the island. It's like a stranger, but set in the island already, that he speaks Catalan, the same language, but another style, another kind, another dialect.
I a partir d'aquí, el que ens va interessar molt a l'hora de fer el càsting, sobretot el càsting dels petits, de la Tina i en Biel, era treballar, el que fem sempre, que és de forma radial. Menorca és una illa molt petita, que hi viuen uns 70 i escaig, no, 1.000 habitants, i hi ha una part del nord, hi ha una ciutat que es diu Ciutadella de Menorca, i llavors el càsting vam començar per allà, d'una manera radial. Allà vam trobar a la Mariona, el que interpreta el personatge de la Tina, el Biel, que és el Macià, que interpreta el personatge això, del Biel, i a Migjorn, com no vam trobar a Ciutadella de Menorca, vam anar fins a Migjorn, que és un petit poble que està al costat de Ciutadella, i allà vam trobar la Mariona.
Yeah, and it was a deep work, especially for the casting of the kids, that Menorca is a small island, it's barely 70,000 inhabitants there, so they start to make like a radial research, starting in Ciutadella, which is the kind of the capital of the island, and first there they found the little kid, Biel, and they have to, but not the girl, so they have to keep looking for, and finally they Tina appears in Migjorn, which is a small village.
I a partir d'aquí ens interessava molt això, respectar aquesta parla i sobretot reflexar tot aquell món, no? És un món insular, mm-hmm. i tota insularitat en aquest sentit a qualsevol illa del món, no? I sobretot aquella època, el 1918, doncs, representa fam, representa mm-hmm. gent que emigra, no? I doncs, hi ha una tradició menorquina molt, molt, mm-hmm. que gairebé són 100 anys, no? Que comença el 1800 i escaig, que molts menorquins per sobreviure anaven a Argèlia.
Mm-hmm. And one of the goals of the films is reflecting or reproduce how is living in an island, how is to feel isolated, how is to live in a small community isolated from the rest, and that's why the language was a really important element, and they want to respect that for building up the identity of the community. And once they are in that community, they also recover other traces, other signals of the community, which are like the hunger, the lack of resources, and for that reason, many people of the island back in that time they emigrate to Algeria, no, to Algeria, because it's kind of close and it was like a new place for resources for them.
Hi ha un llibre molt interessant de l'Albert Camus que es diu L'últim home, no, traduït al català, i que parla molt de tota aquesta època. Albert Camus, la seva àvia i la seva mare eren de Menorca, uh-huh. de costat de Mahó, Sant Lluís, i hi havia tota aquesta història d'aquella gent que necessitava marxar per sobreviure, i a partir d'aquí és quan arrenca la pel·lícula. O sigui, la pel·lícula comença quan aquests nens arriben a la casa del seu tiet, que és un pagès que treballa per un terratinent, i a partir d'aquí doncs descobreixen un món màgic al seu voltant.
So we can quote a special book from Albert Camus, the French writer, The Last Man, which is settled in a community like this and the necessity of living, to leave the place, to look for a new life, and it's really special because the grandma of Albert Camus was from Menorca. So he has all that.
Mother.
Sorry?
The grandmother and
yeah.
your mother.
Yeah, so it has all this spirit in the book. And actually, it's in that point where the book is where and when the film starts. Like the kids without parents going to live in a small house in the middle of the fields with their uncle. And that's the starting point. So. And actually,
I la pel·lícula centra en aquesta mirada d'aquesta nena i d'aquest nen que descobreixen un món que quan el seu oncle està treballant tot el dia a la terra, doncs ells comencen a fer unes excursions mm-hmm. com exploratòries per descobrir el lloc on hi ha l'oncle treballant, i a partir d'aquí arriben a una platja mm-hmm. i en aquesta platja descobriran un personatge molt especial mm-hmm. que viu a la platja, que fa la vida lliure o que està allà, no? Que és el personatge del rom, i després descobriran un veler, no? Un llaüt que, diguem-ne, ha fondejat a la badia.
And actually, that's the starting point, the kids discovering the island as a new magic space, like something in the boundaries of reality and fiction, or fantastic, and they discover everything, all the landscapes, step by step, since they until they arrive to the beach. And in the beach they met Rom, a really special personage, a really special character, who is doing the free life, who is living how he wants. And also they discover in the close to the horizon a small ship, which is also represents the things which comes from abroad and represents the outside of the island, which it's kind of a forbidden thing for them. So what about Rom? Once that we have him in the room.
Oh, what about Rom? We don't know. We don't know what's happened. No, yes, I don't know. It's because this island, Menorca, it's a strategical point in the middle of the Mediterranean Sea. So there is a lot of ships and, como se dice, mariners? And,
sailors.
So a lot of sailors who die in the coast, yeah. You know, when we talk about it in the movie, with the kids. In the movie, well, I talk about everything, eh? But in the movie, you know, I think the look, the look of the of the child, mm-hmm. you know, this idea to discover the life, discover the life like everyone, and I think it's important. And this character, this character Rom, it's a little bit well. All the movie, I think it's kind of a tale. And the part, the magical part, the fantastic part, the part of imaginary world in the head of these two childs who have the mother, their mother, mm-hmm. live in Algeria.
Yeah,
and they Algeria, and they received a letter, mm-hmm. No, you know, so they have the idea to find her mother, their mother, in Algeria, and I don't know. So Rom is a little bit a character. I live a little bit like this, a character, like a tale character, like well, you can feel he's a sailor. Because it's somebody who knows very good the sea and the winds and the nature. Mm-hmm. Because this is the him too, you know. He knows very good Menorca. Menorca in this movie is a wonderful place. It's an incredible place, but don't go to Menorca. It's enough. It's too much people.
And it's world heritage, it has to be protected.
Yes, exactly.
We don't want a lot of tourists.
You don't want a lot of tourists. No, but it's a wonderful place, really wonderful. And the nature is wherever you, well.
I think the tourism department of the island pay for the film. I don't know if we are helping now.
Yes. Like yes. No, but you know that, the island is not just like this. It's not just a picture like this. No. You know, Mark, he knows very good Menorca, and it's really well. We see this sentence a lot of times, but he's really a character in the movie. Mm. The nature, the stones, the herbs, the mm-hmm. tortugas. ¿Cómo son tortugas?
Turtles.
Exactly. Ninja turtles. They are not ninjas, but turtles too. You know?
En tot cas, l'espectador no veurà una imatge de Menorca turística, sinó és una Menorca des d'un punt de vista on es construeix amb aquest treball d'observació, no, que s'ha fet que hem fet al llarg de molt de temps i hem construït una mirada pròpia sobre aquests nens i sobre aquest paisatge, i és una mirada més panteista amb uns elements més animistes, els arbres, mm-hmm. que tenen com vida pròpia, les pedres, el que deia el Sergi, no, el vent. Tot té tot una simbologia molt especial, no? Ja, el vent juga un paper capdalt al final.
Yeah, however, even if we are discussing about this tourist space, we won't find in the film a tourist point of view. It's all the opposite. It's like the whole island is alive, like all the elements, the trees, the old houses, the forbidden corners, the stones. It's a bit animistic, the film. It's like a bit shamanic as well, in a way, because they seem to be alive. They take part in the life of the little siblings, and even the wind, it has an important role in the film, because it's like they are all connected, and they are like tracing and building up the story all together with the activity.
I per mi el repte de la pel·lícula a l'hora d'escriure el guió va ser, després d'aquest treball d'observació dels elements i per intentar construir aquesta mirada pròpia, era com filmem la invisibilitat o l'intangible per després fer-ho molt tangible, perquè la pel·lícula en el fons, per molt subtil que sigui, és molt tangible, mm. és a dir, hi ha els eriçons, hi ha el menjar, hi ha els arbres, hi ha el vent, hi ha la terra, l'esforç, la suor, les olors, no? Perquè no les podem, diguem-ne, en aquest sentit, treballar, no? Filmar, però sí que és com, per mi el més difícil és això. El repte és com filmes el que no és aparent, és a dir, lo intangible, és a dir, perquè estem parlant, i no només parlo del, no només parlo d'un actor, per exemple, del seu estat d'ànim, que també és molt important, i evidentment treballem el llenguatge no verbal, sinó gestual, és a dir, treballem les imatges i tal, no, sinó com entrem en tot aquest univers perquè després això esdevingui molt físic, que en el fons Menorca és això, que és una cosa molt física. Veiem molts planos del Rom, no? Quan està manipulant coses, sempre està fent coses. Hi havia com una obsessió en aquest sentit, i crec que la dificultat d'aquesta pel·lícula, el repte era aquest.
Okay. It will be freestyle translation, because he speak for long. Actually, one of the main challenges of the film was how to capture the invisible, those things that it's totally difficult to catch. And so how to capture that spirit of the island, which is blowing everywhere there and giving life to all the elements, and make it touchable, making like objectable, making all those elements in something really earthy, rooted to the place, and
les accions de la quotidianitat, yeah, no? De la gestualitat, de 10.000 coses, o sigui, aquesta fisicitat, és a dir, de cosa física, de com agafa amb el rom, per exemple, com agafa les cordes, com el conco,
el tiet,
interpretat pel Miquel Gelabert, doncs com va llaurant amb el cavall, tot, quan està fumigant, etc. És a dir, que al final, tot aquest treball per captar aquesta cosa intangible, aquesta invisibilitat, també després fas un treball monumental, sobretot, no només el rodatge, que ja és molt, sinó també la sala de muntatge, amb imatges, amb sons, amb la música, i bé, és com un trencaclosques que vas treballant, i al final el tot és aquesta cosa física. Yeah. I la gent de Menorca, que les poques persones que han vist la pel·lícula, que se senten molt identificades amb aquest paisatge perquè el senten molt seu, molt de la seva infància, una de les coses que els impressionava era això, aquesta cosa física de la pel·lícula.
Yeah, one of the ways was to film the characters, like Konku, the uncle, or Rom, making a lot of handy things, like playing with the rope, working on the soil, doing a lot of things that actually it was the kind of living on back in that time. And then you also add, not only filming, but in the edition room, you also adding sounds, you adding all the, you put the images together, and it's the way to find out and to construct this physicity, which gives the final identity to the film. And the people from Menorca, who the few of them that have seen the film, they recognize that touchable thing, that that physics present in the film, which is kind of a representation of this free spirit that you can still feel in the island.
I després hi ha una cosa que és molt important a la pel·lícula, que és la transmissió del coneixement a través de la paraula.
Aquí és on fa un paper el Rom, no?
Sí, és a dir, que hi ha aquesta tant el personatge del Rom com la veu amb off de la Tina, que és aquest cantó literari de la pel·lícula, que és molt literari. O sigui, el personatge del Rom, que jo em vaig inspirar una mica amb Long John Silver, no?, de l'Illa del Tresor, i amb un altre personatge molt entranyable de molts dels escrits de l'escriptor català Josep Pla, que era l'Armós, que era un personatge que feia la vida lliure, que vivia al Canadell, allà al costat de Begú, no?, i vivia en una barraca, no? Llavors, hi ha aquest personatge, aquesta barreja, no?, que és el personatge del Rom, que sempre explica històries, sempre coses que ell inventa o que ha viscut i que deixa absolutament enlluernats els nens, no? Uh-huh. I llavors, la pel·lícula també té aquest cantó literari amb el rerefons, que és el que va alimentant aquesta fantasia del Rom, que són els submarins alemanys, el contraband, uh-huh, els misteris del mar, bueno, llavors entrem en tot aquest món literari, no?
Yeah, and then another side, it's maybe the literary part of the film, which is how we transmit knowledge, how we share knowledge. And we have, for instance, the voiceover of Tina, which has an important role in the film, but also the stories told by Rom, which is also like a big pope, like explaining, or a big shaman explaining different and transmitting special information to the kids, that they look at him really like they are dreaming in a way. And actually that character was built related or thinking in two other characters, which is one is John Longsilver from the Island of the Treasure, and the other one is from a current character from Josep Pla, from a Catalan writer, El Alermos, the beauty, the beautiful one.
Sorry, que era un personatge molt lleig, que semblava com un, que era d'un físic simiesc.
Yeah, which it was, which it was actually a really ugly animalistic guy, so you have to say thank you to him for that. And okay, so this character from Josep Pla, the beautiful one, was really ugly, but it was like the contrast. And putting together those special characters, we have Rom, which actually, what I remember when the first time I saw the film, I was told that the film was a story about contraband and smuggling, about smuggling in the beginning of 20th century. And then I reflect a little bit, if I never reflect, but I try to I thought a little bit, I say, well, I think it's a story about two kids in an island having their dreams and having their own story and building up different stories and in constantly passing to one layer of reality and another layer of self-construct reality. And I think that in that position, Rome, it's like the intersection. It's like the stone in them. It's a stone because maybe concrete, it's more a tree with roots, and Rome is like a stone river, a river stone, which is the door, it's the gate between this reality that it's there, like the sheep, the smuggling, so on, and the kids and the life that they have in the island.
És que en aquest món de la transfiguració, i no només de la llum, sinó d'aquest estat de transició d'aquests nens que passen, sobretot la Tina, no? Que passa un món, està en un estat de transició per passar al món dels adults. Uh-huh. El personatge del Rom aquí és bàsic, perquè el personatge del Rom representa que podia ser una mena d'oncle, no? De també entranyable i una persona que lluerna aquests nens i els explica 10.000 coses divertides i absurdes, però també és el misteri. És una persona que té coses i hi ha un món de reserva molt important i això va per la Tina, el personatge de la nena, no? La posa en una situació d'aprenentatge valós en la qual se n'adona que els éssers humans no només pot tot ser fantasia i divertiment, sinó de cop i volta hi ha una part també misteriosa o de coses que no s'expliquen. No? Una mica amb aquesta transició, aquest personatge és, bueno, com dius, crec que és cap dels.
Yeah, so in this point we have to consider the glance of Tina, which is a girl who is still not a woman, but she's in this transition point, so it's a new life is also being open to her, and she's like fascinated by Rome, but also has her doubts because she's start to considering different elements, and she's still also building up a new life and has to consider all the point of view. So she's not that fascinated as her brother is with Rome. So how Rome play with the kids? How you?
And how the kids play with Rome. Uh-huh. I don't know if it is, I think it's for, well, kids are something all the times true. Something like this, you know, mm-hmm. After you have to memorize, you are when you go into the technical work, it's another idea, but a kid is a kid. Mm-hmm. You have to invent it something, you mm-hmm. have to imagine, well, even them, but well, we all time we thought that animals, you know, the turtles are already true, and the kids are a little bit like animals, like this. But it was really, it was not really holidays, but
almost.
we try to okay. find the idea of pleasure. And well, you know, when the nature in Menorca is so present and so evident that it's so beautiful, so yeah. beautiful that. But when you work 12 hours in the same beach, that yeah. becomes a little more ugly. You know, yeah. you want to go to somebody, some place ugly and not so beautiful. But we are in the sea. You know, we are really near the sea. We are really between the trees. We are in the nature. So I think we try to work like a little bit like the characters and them. You know, the Rom. Brings them the idea. It's funny in the movie. The Konku, the uncle, and Rom. They are the two adults, the only two adults in the movie. There are two kids and two adults, and it's a little bit two characters, not antagonist completely because they have a common points, but well, Rom is the uncle, work and have the idea of the future. Well, we don't know, but we can imagine that the future, well, is death, you know. Yeah. and Rom bring this idea to the fiction, to I think that this idea to imagine.
To
but some that's why we are in Tallinn too, but with something dark too.
Yeah.
Something okay. He have a knife all the time, and mm-hmm. we don't know. It's for the a lot of things, but. You don't know exactly what he's doing, where he lives near the sea in a barraca,
house, yeah.
as in a small house
a
like
cottage,
this. No? He knows every plant and animals and eat, but we don't know exactly what he's doing there. And he's not from Menorca, you know.
So
he has another accent.
Away.
So what he has, what he's waiting here? Because you can imagine that he waits for something. And he looks all the time. He's very interested to this little ship in the sea. Well, and there is a lot of questions that maybe we have not the answer. Maybe
well,
him,
we have
maybe
we have to watch the film for that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually.
Yeah.
We are in few hours having the.
Una cosa per complementar el que estàveu parlant abans dels nens. De la bé, de les capacitats de quan treballes amb ells i tal. Jo crec que hi ha una cosa interessant en el cine, perquè no s'ha d'oblidar que el cine no només ho fa la pel·lícula, no només la fa el director, sinó la pel·lícula és un treball d'equip i per tant és una gran aventura humana, no? Amb tots els ets i els uts, les nostres contradiccions, etc, etc. Però el que sí que és interessant és agafar nanos o gent que no en sap o que mai ha tingut una experiència davant d'una càmera i aquestes mescles amb gent que porta moltes hores de vol, que té molta experiència i es creen unes situacions de vegades molt interessants que no deixa de ser un joc de miralls, d'aprenentatge mutu d'uns i dels altres. I en el fons tots es van empenyent. O sigui que, i no només amb la part dels actors, sinó de vegades també amb l'equip tècnic. Posar gent com l'Alain Lubach, per exemple, que té una capacitat increïble, que ha fet molts llargmetratges com a directora de fotografia, és el mateix. De vegades ens venen col·laboradors que no en saben tant o que no tenen tantes hores de vol i això incentiva uns i els altres. Era només per complementar
sí.
una mica.
So, to make a film is not only filming and to be a director and doing it, but it's putting a big team together. And sometimes it's putting people who comes from the real life, so to say, and with people who with a long experience and put them together is what build up a new thing. And it's like a game of mirrors, which make one push to the other and building up something. So it's what also make this film interesting, how they build up a new thing up from different origins or different sources. I was saying that in few hours that we have the international premiere of the film right after being in Gijón this same week. And you just, I think you quote already two of the elements that makes the film really catchy. First one is that you watch it and you feel that you are in holidays. Especially if you are in Tallinn and we are during Black Night, so you jump totally into Menorca and in totally another season and stage. Yeah. Another one is this like cozy and maybe as well as catchy character of Rom, which is a really mysterious guy. Give me more reasons for going tonight to see the film.
Bueno, és una pel·lícula que s'ha de mirar. És una pel·lícula que s'ha de mirar amb un estat d'ànim concret, perquè a la vida tenim diferents estats d'ànim, uns dies estem més contents, altres dies més pensits, més feliços o tal. I sí que és una pel·lícula que convida a deixar-te anar, no? I si estàs en un estat d'ànim propici a això, és meravellós, és com un conte, no? Et van explicant com tota una història, amb una veu amb off, i és una pel·lícula molt sensual en aquest sentit, no? On, insisteixo, la cosa física és molt important, i hi ha aquesta mena de lirisme contingut, bueno, més suggerit, és com un poema japonès, i a la vegada és una pel·lícula molt literària, molt d'aventures, molt d'un món que tothom s'hi pot sentir identificat, perquè quanta gent s'ha passat, no sé, amb una grip al llit o que tenia qualsevol cosa i no ha anat a l'escola, llegia llibres, imaginava un món, coses.
So it's a film that you have, maybe you need to have a certain mood that day, but if you have the mood, helps you a lot to let you go, to leave your body for few minutes and enjoy and have like let your imagination go, and you can even feel reflected on the film because each one of us open the brain sometimes and play with different elements.
Me, I think that you know, it's good to go to this movie if you like cinema.
I think that's a perfect sentence.
No, it's because because you know cinema. I said that because sometimes you know. Well, I'm not really very cinephile, you know, but I have an idea, maybe simple idea, but more and more I think cinema, television, you know, the edition. Mm-hmm. Now it's you feel the edition all the time, time, and here you feel the wine. You feel the wine, really. You hear the wine. You hear the sea. You are a transport, you know. For me, that's what the cinema can help us.
Okay. I think with this is the perfect closing.
We see.
Like you have to see this film if you love cinema and enjoy the wind. Thank you very much. Moltes gràcies per ser aquí. Aita.
Thank you. Bye-bye.